Well, hello, shirlierox here. Welcome back to Medieval Dynasty, episode 65, I believe this is now. Let me check. I think it is 65. Yes. Right, so we've got a few things to do. Number one is I have broken roofs. Apparently, some of my buildings have fishing huts broken. What else is broken? I'm sure some of my houses are. I think it might just be my house. Oh no, it's fishing hut and my house, so these both have issues apparently. Let me go and double check. Where was my crib? Shirl's crib was all the way over here. It was... I always forget where my own house is. Yeah, maybe it's the one with my wife in. Oh, it's inside, look. Walking so slow. Yeah. Okay, sorry wife. I'm a terrible husband. Let's go and see if we have free apples.
Is anything troubling you, my dear?
What's on your mind? No. I have a favour to ask you. We have a debt to pay. Would you take this money? Nothing. Can we just talk to her? Because we can romance, but we... Yeah. Let's just be well.
See you soon.
It's not really that good a thing we're doing to her, is it? Yeah, so I've got to go and fix the fishing shed or the fishing hut. Now, I've got a few ideas of how to improve the town because we're getting self-sufficient, but we have a problem at the moment, which is stone. Now, I will show you in a second. Just fix this. Okay. More broken. There you go. Okay, everything should be fixed now. Right, so yeah, I've got a problem with production. I've got some nice amount of wood at the moment. So I think I've got about 640-odd things of wood coming at the moment from, well, sticks from the sheds. I've got 80 logs coming in, and I've got, I think, I've switched one of these out to make firewood. So that's doing 220 sticks. This one here is doing 222 sticks. This one is doing firewood, so we're doing 44 a day. And that one is, that's 80 logs in that one. And 29, so that's like 100 logs a day. So, I'm wondering if I've got too many logs, because we're not really utilising a lot of this, if you know what I mean. I probably have a silly amount of logs stored, but the thing that I've noticed in this game is, it's like here, I've got 129 stored. Now, the thing I've noticed with this is, you get a load of one item and then all of a sudden you don't have enough. So for instance, I've got like, let me show you my cabbage collection. I have 680 cabbages, which are too much for me to carry, and I'm not really utilizing, and we're not really making any food at the moment because I have got so many problems. So we've got the kitchen. Now the kitchen is making potage, which is cabbage and meat. Now, it's not making it at the moment because we're missing resources. Now, we need to have at least 8 meat a day. And we are not actually matching that at the moment because we're only making 21 meat a day because we need to keep the leather. This is where it's so complicated, this game. I need to have X amount of leather a day, and I think it was 13 because the sewing hut in here needs 13 a day. So it's like micromanaging all of this, which I find a little bit frustrating. I think I set it to that to try and get over the amount. So let's bump that up a little bit. Plus the skills of the people working in these as well has a knock-on effect of it. I've got a level 5 hunter, a level 2 hunter, a level 3 hunter. Once they've leveled up a little bit, I imagine it's going to be, you know, it's going to be a lot easier. So, yeah, the problems I've got at the moment is the main blocker is my smithy, I think. Now, I've got two people working in here. They're literally doing nothing because we've not got enough resources to make all this stuff. So we're making two axes a day, 81 knives, wooden hoes, pickaxes. And yeah, we're not doing any of that at the moment because if you look at the requirements, 177 stone a day. That is ridiculous. Sticks, we're using 476 and making 600. That's not a problem. Logs shouldn't be a problem. So stone. Now, if we look at the stats for... This has turned into an Excel episode. Sorry about that. So if we look at my extraction hut, where have you gone? Up here we go. Yeah, I've got one extraction shed, which is 94% intensity, and I'm only getting 70 stone a day. So I've get rid of all of this and whack that up, but that only gives me 73 stone a day. So I'm beginning to think I need another extraction hut. But again, problems. I have a level 3 and a level 4 in there, and that is 2. If I get another extraction hut, then we are going to double our stuff to like 140. That's still not really going to be enough. So I really don't know what I'm going to do with the production. I'm wondering if knives are not the way to go, if I should have them making something else. We've got like loads of bars and stuff. It's not really going that good. And I can start making copper as well. I have been collecting a little bit of copper. Let's actually see how much copper we've got. So we'll hide that. Oh, it doesn't tell me. Right, let's go and check it out. Because I have been doing like one bar of copper a day. Well, the ore, so... Maybe I should move up into the next production level, which is the copper rather than stone. What are you doing with that stick? Training to be a wizard, I think. Okay, we've got so far to go. Right, finally, I'm near the Shed of Plenty. Right. Let's have a little look. What are my stocks like in here? So, and I do know I have a silly amount of hoes. So, right, so we've got 55 knives, 3 pickaxes. Oh, interesting. We have not got a silly amount of hoes. Now, I think that's probably because the busy planting, so they're probably absolutely chewing for those. So, tin ore, we've got 9. Copper ore, we have 3. Yeah, so we've not really been collecting much of that at all. So, I'm unsure how to micromanage this at the moment. It's because we've also got problems with the sewing hut as well. Again, no resources. So, we can't make the coif because we need linen fabric. And linen fabric, we are not making a lot of that. We make that from the thread. And the thread is from the stalks. I know for a fact I've got about 35 flax stalks. Let me show you. Yeah, I've got 34. So I don't know how to make this a little bit quicker. I mean, I suppose I could either get someone new to work in the sewing hut and double their output. Or, yeah, let's do that. Right. So we need to upgrade my sewing hut, so we are going to upgrade you finally. So buildings, production, come on. And we'll do a level 2 sewing hut for this, and then we're going to see what we need to upgrade. Whoa, what are you doing? What are you doing? You hurt your back? Okay. Okay, you do you. Right, we need to get my hammer out. Right, this is going to take me a while to upgrade because apparently I need loads of logs. Do I need planks? Planks are normally the thing that annoy me. Okay, we should have enough. Let's get this done. Okay, ready to put the finishing touches to this now. So we now have a level 2 hut. Doesn't look much different than the other one apart from we put walls on it. I'm sure it must be better that I can put more people in it. So if I go to sewing hut now, do you know what? We can't. Now what's the difference with that? So I thought a sewing hut level 2 would mean I could have more people in it. What's new in it? More sturdy. Okay, so that's entirely not what I wanted from an upgraded sewing hut. I thought I could get 2 people in it. Let's get the assignment back on. Let's try and get someone in it that is actually a decent level this time. So, I'm looking for level 4. I think we might take the... I might put the blacksmith in here. Yeah, you go in here. And then... if I go back to this... We need to mix this up a little bit, so... let's not worry so much about making those coif things. Let's worry more about making things like the lined fabric. So we've got to check the requirements. We've got like 35 in stock. So let's stick that lined fabric up to the levels we've got, which is 35. So it needs to be a little bit lower than that. Okay, let's check that. Hate the way you can't click on that. Let's see, let's do confirm. There you go, you can do it like that. Okay, 32. Yeah, that'll do. And then we're making leather bags, which is, well, simple bags, not leather bags. I think that is what we're using the leather for each. Actually, that's interesting. Pretty sure the leather before was on 13 a day I was getting. Just wondering if I should wang this up, the linen fabric. So that's one a day. See, I don't know what am I best doing for leveling up the skill on this. Am I best just making simple bags and stocking up linen thread and the linen fabric? Because that uses linen fabric uses one linen thread a day, so I'm making 6 a day. So I could then turn the linen fabric into I could turn the thread into fabric. Okay, that sells for 80. That sells. I mean, I suppose it's worth doing. Not really got the intensity to do it though. So we're making 6 of that a day, then we're turning that into 4. We're making that amount of bags, which is probably, let's confirm that. And I have got 13 leather a day. Yeah, so that is a deficit. So this needs to be slightly different. Let's reduce that to, like, say, I don't know, 40. And do that up. Let's confirm it with F. Go to this now. We're still using loads of leather a day. Why are we doing so much leather a day? I want to do less bags. Right, do that to 30%. Will that do? Okay. I'll confirm that. And that means we're not going to use all our leather, but it means we are going to use all the flax. Right, now we know we're doing that, let's go and check out the fields, because I've not got a clue what is going on with the fields. I think the extra hoes have all been used as well, so we might have hoe problems in a bit. Now that to me looks like that is ready to harvest. Look at it. Is that ready to harvest? I don't think I've actually got a thing. Wheat. That wheat is surely ready to harvest. So, we're planting all of that. Are you actually putting fertilizer down? Oh no, we're actually collecting the cabbages. I think I might have to make sure I've got loads of... yeah, I think we might need to go and check our production. Because it doesn't say that we've not got anyone doing it, but I'm a bit suspicious that this farming isn't getting done. Right, so we've got no sickles in stock. It's not giving me a warning, though. Right, let me just go and make a few of these and be right back. Okay, so I'm really suffering with not enough materials. So I could go and absolutely rinse the amount of stone and stuff I've got. But I think I might need to make me some copper stuff. So I've made... Oh, I've only got one copper bar. That's nowhere near enough. So
no worries.
Let me have a little look. I think I need two... Yeah, I need two iron bars to make that. So, because I want to make more of these. So if we go to stone tools, I need sticks and stones. And I just haven't got enough sticks and stones at the moment. So I think I'm going to have to go and do this all manually. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to leave that there for now because this is going to be a little short episode. It's just showing about the production and stuff. So seems to be the major problems we have at the moment is my stone production is absolutely non-existent. And I am struggling with producing enough material. So the only thing I can think I might do is I'm going to have to build another extraction thing, an excavation shed, and have that one just collecting stone. That's the only way I think I can solve my problem with stone, because I have one extraction shed, and as you can see, we are currently producing 73 stone a day, and that's not even collecting copper. So I could be really ideally, right, hear me out. This is gonna be so much work. Ideally, I need another extraction hut collecting just stone, and then another extraction hut just collecting like either just copper or a mixture of copper, clay and limestone, because there's loads we can do with the buildings as well. I have not upgraded all my buildings yet. As you can see on this, I can add insulation. I need loads of door, which is loads of clay. So, oh, I'm so busy. What do you think I should do next? Anyway, that is it for now. Medieval Dynasty. I'm shirlierox. See you next time.